Hello everyone, we move on to module 3, which is classification of soil. So before we start with the concept and principles of classification of soil, let us try to identify the learning outcomes for this chapter. So at the end of this module, the students are expected to define textural classification of soil, describe how the classification by engineering behavior provides advantage over textural classification, apply the ASHTO classification system to classify a soil, apply the unified soil classification system to classify a soil, describe the differences and similarities of the ASHTO and unified soil classification system. So basically, the purpose of soil classification system is to group together soils with similar attributes. From the engineering standpoint, it is the geotechnical properties such as permeability, shear strength, and compressibility that are important. So the first step, however, in classifying a soil is to identify it. So different soil with similar properties will be classified into groups and subgroups according to their engineering behavior. Classification systems provide a common language to concisely express the general characteristics of soil, which are infinitely varied without detailed descriptions. Most of the soil classification systems that have been developed for engineering purposes are based on simple index properties such as particle size distribution and plasticity. Although several classification systems are now in use, none is totally definitive of any soil for all possible application because of the wide diversity of soil properties. So, in general, we have identified two major categories into which the classification system are developed. So we have what we call the textural classification. This textural classification is based on the particle size distribution of the percent of sand, silt, clay size fraction present in a given soil subtopology. So the second one is the major category, which is based on the engineering behavior of soil and takes place into consideration the particle size distribution and the plasticity, which includes liquid limit and plasticity index. So under this category for the engineering behavior in soil classification, we have used the ASHTO classification system and the unified classification system. So to start with, we have the first one, which is our So we have the first classification, the textural classification. So the texture of the soil refers to its surface appearance. So texture is influenced by the size of its components. Soils are generally mixtures of particles from several size groups and are named after their principal components. So the USDA textural classification system categorizes soil based on the presentation of sand, silt, and clay. So for classification system, soil classification system, they make use of this USDA textural classification, or what we call the US Department of Agricultural textural classification. So if you're going to observe based on this figure, so actually the classification method is based on the particle size limit as described by the USDA on a certain tabulation wherein you have the sand size, which is 2 to 0.05 mm in diameter, silt size, which is 0.05 to 0.002 mm in diameter, and the clay size is 0.002 mm in diameter. So for this one, we make use of this triangular textural classification to classify a certain soil sample. So what is present here is the percentage of sand at the bottom, we have the percentage of silt, and we have the percentage of clay. So how do we use this textural classification system? So to use that one, we're going to have identify a certain soil sample given with a certain percentage of clay, percentage of silt, and percentage of sand. So meaning to say you have a soil, it has a percentage of clay, it has a percentage of silt, and percentage of sand. So whatever is the percentage, you have to plot that one. For example, you have a soil sample wherein the percentage of sand is 30. So if the percentage of sand is 30, you locate that on this portion, then you draw a line upward. So that is now 30 percentage of sand. Then you have a percentage of silt on the soil sample, which is 40%. So from here, this is the percentage of silt, you locate 40. So you draw a line. So you have now your 40%. The last one is the percentage of clay. For example, the percentage of clay is 30. So if that is 30, you locate 30 in the percentage of clay, you draw a line. Then at a certain point, the three lines will have an intersection. So that particular intersection, you locate that and you read that is now the classification on that soil sample. So the intersection for a given example is at this point, which is clay loam. So meaning to say the soil sample is identified now, it is being classified as clay loam. So what if you have a soil sample, you are given with the percentage of clay, there is a percentage of sand, there's a percentage of silt, and there is a percentage of gravel. So basically, you cannot immediately use the structure classification if there is a presence of gravel because we don't have a percentage of gravel in the structure classification. So what we're going to do before we can use this one is to modify our percentage of clay, percentage of silt, and percentage of sand. So to modify that one, for example, you have this illustration. So you have a soil sample wherein you have a 20% gravel, you have a 10% sand, you have a 30% silt, and you have 40% clay. So meaning to say you cannot identify its classification using the texture classification because of this percentage of gravel. So what you're going to do is you are going to modify our sand size, silt size, and clay size. How we modify? You're going to have the percentage of clay in the numerator, percentage of clay multiplied to 100% over 100% subtracted by the percentage of gravel. And that is now your percentage of sand. For the percentage of silt or the silt size, you have 30. Percentage of silt multiplied to 100% or over 100% minus the percentage of gravel, that is now 37.5%. This is your silt size or the percentage of silt. For the clay size, this is 40% times 100. This is the 40% of clay times 100 all over 100 minus 20. And this is the 20% of gravel, and that is equal to 50%. So this is now the percentage of clay. After you have modified, this is now the modified percentage of our sand, silt, and clay. Once you have modified this one, you have now modified, there is now no percentage of gravel on the modified textural composition. So you're going to identify, you classify now your soil sample using our textural classification system. What we have done in a previous discussion, same procedure, you just plot your 12.5%, 37.5%, and 50% on our textural classification. You have to take note that once you plot the line, it should be parallel to the line it represents on each sand, silt, and clay percentage. So on the basis of the preceding modified percentages, the USDA textural classification is clay. However, so based on our modified, if you're going to plot this one, this example, the result in the textural classification was clay. So meaning to say it was classified, the soil sample was classified as clay. However, because of the percentage of gravel, it can be called as gravelly clay. So to identify more specific, because of the presence of gravel, it can be called as gravelly clay. So that is now your classification for the soil sample. Several other textural classification can also be used, but they are no longer useful for civil engineering purposes. So basically, since we are civil engineers, we cannot basically identify or classify our soil using only a textural classification. We have to go into a deeper classification of a certain sample that will be used in the construction of a certain structure. So textual classification is based entirely on this particle size distribution. It does not account for the type of clay minerals which influences its physical properties. So we are going to resolve that through classification by engineering behavior, because we are after with the presence of plasticity on our soil sample that is very useful as we try to analyze the properties of soil for the analysis and design of a certain structure. So in this engineering classification by engineering behavior, we make use now of the ASHTO system and our unified soil classification system. It uses the Atterberg limits to account for plasticity. So